Hey guys, welcome back to Wentworth Life. So, if this is your first time here, then hit that subscribe button right now for all future updates. All my social media links are underneath this video, and if you stick around until the end of the video, I will be responding to some of your comments from my previous videos. Okay guys, I am back today with a new spoiler and predictions video for you all. So a couple of weeks ago, I posted a video of spoiler photos, and I said that I will be making another video to talk about these spoiler photos in a lot more detail. Well, I wanted to wait for a few episodes to go past before I talked about them, because I believe a lot of these spoiler photos are going to be happening in the next few episodes, and I wanted to have a bit more of an understanding of how the storylines were going before I chat about them. So let's start with these. So we have a few photos of Rita and Ruby in a cell together, and they both look slightly defeated in these photos. Now I'm thinking that maybe the police aren't going to believe them about Jones and Morelli, and they're both probably looking at a long stretch in Wentworth. Moving on to the next few photos now, and we have all the women in the dining room together. Now in two of these dining room photos, straight away I noticed that Mari is sitting on the same table with Boomer, which I thought was very interesting, and I'm pretty sure Boomer is talking to Mari at one point. And then there are these other dining room photos, but I think this could be a different scene because Mari is sitting with Ali in these photos. So I definitely think this is a separate dining room scene. But what's interesting is how everyone seems to be sitting together. I mean, Lou is just chilling against the table next to Boomer, and we can see that Ruby seems to be trying to talk to everyone, or she's making some sort of speech. And all the women who are looking at Ruby, they don't seem impressed at all. And then in the next photo, we can see that Rita is behind Ruby. So I have a feeling that the women are all going to find out that Rita used to be an undercover police officer. And all the women, I mean all the women, have turned their backs on Rita and Ruby, including Ali. If this is the case, this is going to be quite heartbreaking to watch. And I believe in this scene, Ruby is trying to tell all the women the full story about what's happened, and trying to promise them that Rita isn't a cop anymore and that she can be trusted. I have a feeling that Detective Jones is going to leak this information to the women at Wentworth about Rita being an undercover cop, hoping that the women will kill Rita and Ruby, because we've seen in this week's episode that Detective Jones is getting nervous, and he even killed Eddie, and he knows that he needs to do something to try and keep Rita and Ruby quiet. I can't imagine Mari being too happy when she finds out that Rita was placed into Wentworth undercover to do a job on her. And this might explain these next two photos, where we have Mari going nuts about something in the laundry, and she is being dragged away by the officer. So this could be Mari going mad with Rita and Ruby. Either that, or Mari has been set up by someone. In these next couple of photos, we have Lou Kelly crying on the floor of her cell, which I don't think we've seen these in the first four episodes. Now, I'm assuming that this could happen in next week's episode, episode 5, because Lou had that letter from Reb's mum this week, and Lou was really pissed off about the gravestone saying, "May she rest in peace." So I think Lou is going to have another breakdown next week in episode 5, and once again we have Mari coming in to comfort Lou. But in this photo we have Mari looking into the cell, and she's looking a little bit menacing here in my opinion. And in this next one she's looking a little bit guilty. So I'm wondering whether if Lou comes out with another shocking plan that she wants to do to the prison, and maybe this is shocking Mari, I'm not sure. But sticking with Mari for the moment, we have Mari Mari and Ali alone together in what I think is Ali's unit, and it looks like that they are having a little bit of a heart-to-heart in this scene. We then have Ruby appearing, and she seems to be telling Mari and Ali something, and Mari seems to have a serious look on her face. I wonder what is happening. These next photos reveal that we have got some tense scenes coming up between Anne and Judy Bryant. So Anne, Linda, and Judy are alone somewhere in the prison, and Judy is handcuffed and chained to some bars, and Anne has got one of those big batons, and she is hitting and beating Judy with it. Anne looks like she means real business here, so I'm wondering whether if Anne does discover that Judy was part of the same terrorist group that killed her daughter, and now Anne wants to sort Judy out once and for all. It looks very intense, and look at Linda's face. Linda is looking worried here, but I think Linda could be too scared to say anything or to stop Anne, just in case it ruins her chances of being governor, because that's what Linda really wants. These photos do reveal that Vera ends up on the scene, and her and Anne are having some seriously heated words. Like, I really don't know what the outcome will be from this after Vera catches them, but it looks very intense. Okay, so now we've got some gruesome photos where it looks like Eve Wilder has either had her eyeball removed or it's just seriously damaged. Either way, it looks disgusting. I think the fact that in this week's episode it was mentioned about how a woman at Blackmoor lost an eyeball, this makes me think that Eve is going to lose hers. I have no idea whether if Joan forces Eve to do it herself or if Joan actually pins Eve down on the floor and removes it herself. Personally, I don't know how anyone would be able to remove their own eyeball, as it would be excruciating pain. But if Eve is crazy enough, she might do it on purpose and then blame Joan and tell the officers. I do think this scene could be just as gruesome as the Juicy Lucy tongue scene, if not worse. Look at Linda's face when she discovers Eve on the floor. She looks absolutely horrified. I'm wondering whether if this is just one scene from a chain of events that's all happening at the same time. Oh, it's gonna be intense and insane. I tell you what, guys, my partner Peter, I don't know how he's gonna cope when this happens, because he has a serious thing about eyeballs. Like, he doesn't even like a close-up of just an eyeball on screen, let alone an eyeball being removed from its socket. Oh god, I literally do not know how he's gonna cope. We then have these photos in the laundry. So we have Lou on the press as top dog. And then we have a worried looking Judy. And in a few of these photos, it looks like all the women are giving a certain look at someone. And it's almost as if they're all onto Judy. This could be coming up very soon in the next episode or two. And then we have these photos of Judy being terrorized by all the women. Like, literally all the women seem to come together to teach Judy a lesson, and I cannot wait for this. So we have Judy on the floor having food thrown at her, followed by Judy being thrown into that bin full of water. And I bet that's dirty bin juice water as well. Ugh. And at one point, the women are slamming that bin lid down onto Judy. I reckon Judy is going to be dunked until she's nearly passing out. And then they will bring her back up for air a number of times. And then Judy is going to be pleading with Lou to stop. Now, I have a feeling that Ali is going to tell Lou about Judy stealing the money. But I don't think Lou is going to 100% believe Ali. So during these dunking scenes, I reckon Lou isn't going to stop torturing Judy until she admits everything. That she stabbed Ali, and that she took her and Reb's money, and to admit that she is a terrorist. It's all going to come out during this scene, and I can't flipping wait. And in this photo, I reckon Judy admits everything, and just when we think Lou is going to drown Judy, Lou pulls her out of the bin and throws her to the floor. Lou then picks her up and puts her arms around her and makes Judy her bitch. And Lou is going to make Judy help her with her plans to destroy Wentworth once and for all. And this brings me on to these photos. So we have Judy and Lou together, which I think is probably in Lou's unit. And in these two photos, they are looking out of the window. I reckon Lou is going to plan a huge riot at Wentworth, but is also going to get Judy to make a bomb to go off in Wentworth right in the middle of this riot. And then Lou tells Judy that once they have blown the prison apart, then they can both escape. And this could be them looking out of the window planning the escape, where they're going to be climbing a fence. However, I don't think Lou will take Judy with her, not a chance. I think Lou is just saying this to get Judy to make the bomb. I then reckon that Lou will murder Judy at the very last moment, just before Lou makes her escape. And this then brings me onto these photos, which are some of the most dramatic and devastating photos I have ever seen from Wentworth. So the bomb has gone off and Ali is alone in her wheelchair, surrounded by a totally destroyed looking Wentworth. So Ali is stuck by the looks of things. And if you notice in this photo, we can see a dead body on the floor, and I think it's one of those background officers. Now in these photos, Ali doesn't seem to have a cut on her face, but in other photos, she has. So I'm thinking part of the ceiling is going to cave in at some point, and Ali is going to have no choice but to throw herself out of the chair and try her best to try and climb through the rubble. And this will explain why she seems to have more cuts in other photos. And in these photos, we can see Ali under some rubble. So I do think the roof is going to cave in and she's going to get herself trapped. I just really hope that Ali manages to get saved. These episodes, guys, wow, just these photos, it's going to be crazy. These are off the scale. It's going to be incredible viewing. And even though these photos show that a bomb is going to go off and the prison is going to be destroyed, it only shows Ali in peril. Like, where is everyone else? This makes me very nervous for all of our favorite characters. It's going to be insane. So we got some huge, unforgettable episodes on our way, and I definitely think Lou is going to get Judy to help her with a riot and a bomb. Also, with these new punishment benches, it's got me thinking, if Lou does take over the prison during a prison riot and grabs herself a few hostages, how amazing would it be if one of those hostages was Anne Reynolds, and Lou and the women chain Anne to one of their own punishment benches while they torture her? Now that I would love to see. I definitely think those benches are going to play a big part in the bigger episodes later this season. I still have a feeling that Vera might end up in Teal. I don't know why, it's just a feeling. I reckon maybe by the end of episode 7, Vera could be arrested for whatever reason. I mean, you could literally take your pick at this stage. And I think she's going to end up in prison with her nemesis, Ferguson. Oh god, how epic and twisted would that be? I would lose my mind. So would some of you guys. It would be absolutely crazy. I mean, whatever happens, this season is going to blow our minds. I mean, look at how much has happened in the first 4 episodes of this season. And I reckon this is just the calm before the storm. The best is definitely yet to come. And as for who's going to end up in that bloody freezer, well, at the moment, I feel it could be Jake with this Eve Wilder storyline that's going on at the moment. But that could change after next week's episode. Who knows? Whoever ends up in that freezer, they are definitely not giving any spoilers away, not even in these photos. So we will just have to wait and see. But for the moment, I think it could be Jake. I also have another tragic theory about Rita and Ruby. So let's say Ruby doesn't die, and her and Rita are caught up in this huge explosion towards the end of the season. What if Rita and Ruby are together when the bomb goes off, and then when Rita gets up and looks around at what's just happened, Rita then sees a very badly injured Ruby, and Rita goes over to her, but Ruby, she's lost all her limbs, and she's in a real bad way. Like, Like, Ruby has got blood coming out of her and she literally does not have long to live. Imagine how tragic it would be if Rita tries to wait for help to come, but realizes it's not going to come quick enough, and Ruby asks Rita to end it for her. And Rita is forced to put Ruby out of her misery, her sister who she's always protected. It would be an absolute tragic end for these characters, and I tell you what, guys, even while I'm telling you this story, I've almost got tears in my eyes. And Rita would definitely go looking for Lou in those final scenes, and this might explain why Rita and Lou, they've both got those stunt doubles by the fence, which would probably explain that they're probably both gonna have a final fight scene. So guys, let me know your thoughts in the comments box below about these photos. Do you think Lou is going to make Judy her bitch and force her to make a bomb to blow up the prison? Or do you think someone else is going to be responsible for this huge explosion that we've got coming up? Let me know all your thoughts in the comments box below. And on that note, it's now time for some comment replies. So we have Sin B. I thought for a moment that Ali was going to see B when she was at the dentist looking at the island image while being under the effects of nitrous oxide. Yes, Sin B, this is literally what I thought as well. I seriously think we could be in for a B appearance, and this is the writer's way of teasing us. So you never know, we could get a B ghost vision to Ali's, particularly after this bomb explosion, because we've seen these photos now of Ali in some serious danger, so maybe B will come to her and give us some strength, who knows. Thank you for your comment. And we have Aretha Franklin Whitney Houston. Great predictions in there. I hope they don't have Boomer die. She's one of the originals from the start. If you haven't seen the trailer for tonight's episode, check it out. Yes, well, I don't want Boomer to die either. But something's telling me if they want to make this final episode shocking, somebody unexpected has to die. Not just a villain, not just like Joan Ferguson or Jake Stewart. Has to be somebody unexpected who we think is safe. And for me, it could be one or two people, and it's either Boomer or Vera. So we'll just have to keep our fingers crossed on this one. But anyway, thank you for your comment. And we have Jacob Hall. Yay, I've been waiting for this for ages. I watched this show with my mum, and I told her about your channel. So we've been enjoying your dissection of the episodes. This was probably Ali's best episode ever, and I almost see Lou hopefully becoming a sort of anti-hero now. Aw, thank you, Jacob. That's such a nice comment. And thank you, mum, too, as well. I'm glad that you both enjoy the channel. You could be onto something. I've always said Lou could be an amazing top dog for those women. She knows how to control them, but unfortunately at the moment, she's still on the villainous side of the fence, but you never know what could happen. But thank you for your comment, Jacob. And we have Danny San. Episode 4 was amazing. Judy was so creepy when she went to kiss Ali, but I'm glad Ali finally knows. And Ferguson and Eve bonding over murder was weirdly cool. I have to agree with you. It was so messed up, but it was so enjoyable because it's not something that you see on everyday television, and it was just fascinating viewing. And yes, I agree. I am so happy that Ali now knows the truth. Thank you for your comment, and thank you all for your amazing comments. Keep them coming, and maybe next time one of your comments will get featured in my next video. Okay, well, if you're still here, then thank you all for sticking around until the end of the video. Make sure you smash that subscribe button, stay safe, and I'll see you all again very soon.